Amrajihawa Brakata Yahusha Brakjihawa Brakata Yahusha Bahashan Rakagwadash. Double honors to the apostles, the elders. Salutations to you, sincere brothers, teaching in truth and in sincerity. Lesson will be entitled Vanished Source. Natural News article entitled Too Fat to Fight. 10,000 U.S. Army soldiers are now too obese to serve, and a quarter of young men can't even qualify for recruitment. Published on April 5th, 2023. If another country wanted to invade and take over the U.S., it would be really easy to do so right now because a growing number of American soldiers is too fat to fight. Blaming the fill-in-the-blank for the military's obesity problem, the Associated Press reported that in the Army branch of the military alone, nearly 10,000 active duty soldiers developed obesity between February 2019 and June 2021. Because of this, nearly 25% of Army troops are now too big to do their jobs. The situation is not much different in the Navy and the Marines. Too much sitting inside during the lockdowns, eating fill-in-the-blank slop food has left service members in the U.S. military in poorer shape than the average civilian in a foreign country where fill-in-the-blank and other garbage are not part of the food supply. I could notice it, said U.S. Army Staff Sergeant Daniel Murillo, 27, who reportedly spent endless hours on his laptop during the fill-in-the-blank while he chowed down on cookies and chips in the barracks at Fort Bragg in North Carolina. The uniform was tighter, Murillo told the AP about how his body became misshapen during the fill-in-the-blank. Ever since the fill-in-the-blank began dominating headlines, the obesity situation in the U.S. military has only continued to worsen. Between all the fill-in-the-blank soldiers receive, the junk food they eat, and the lack of physical fitness, the U.S. military has become a mere shell of what it once was. The Army and other services need to focus on how to bring the forces back to fitness, said Tracy Perez, director of the Center for Health Services Research at the Uniformed Services University and Bethesda, Maryland, who led new research on the subject. If military service members remain fat and sickly, as many of them now are, then they risk succumbing to more injuries and failing to meet the physical demands necessary for their profession. According to Tracy's assessment, the U.S. military loses more than 650,000 workdays a year because of all the extra weight its service members are packing on, not to mention the $1.5 billion in obesity-related health care costs that are incurred by both current and former service members and their families. Marine Corps Brigadier General Stephen Cheney co-authored his own report on the subject, which arrived at grim conclusions. The numbers have gotten better, Cheney told participants in a November webinar held by the American Subject Project, a nonprofit think tank. They are just getting worse and worse and worse. For the first time ever, the U.S. Army failed to achieve its recruiting goal in fiscal year 2022, falling short by about 15,000 recruits, or about one quarter of the recruitment. The alleged reason for this is the fact that 3/4 of Americans aged 17 to 24 are not eligible for military service, in part due to being fat. Obesity is now the biggest individual disqualifier, affecting more than 1 in 10 potential recruits, according to the report. It's devastating, he reported. And again, he stated, the numbers have not gotten better. What? The numbers have not gotten better. Okay? And again, these supposed to be men of war. Okay? Experts in war, in physical shape, in great physical shape. Let's go to 2 Samuel 23. And let's start at verse 8.
These be the names of the mighty men whom David had. The Tachmonite that sat in the seat, chief among the captains, the same was Adino the Esnite. He lift up his spear against 800, whom he slew at one time. And after him was Eleazar the son of Dodo the Ahohite, one of the three mighty men with David when they defied the Philistines that were there gathered together to battle, and the men of Israel were gone away. He arose and smote the Philistines until his hand was weary, and his hand clave unto the sword, and the Lord wrought a great victory that day, and the people returned after him only to spoil. And after him was Shammah the son of Agi the Harite. And the Philistines were gathered together into a troop, where was a piece of ground full of lentils, and the people fled from the Philistines. But he stood in the midst of the ground, and defended it, and slew the Philistines. And the Lord wrought a great victory. And 3 of the 30 chief went down, and came to David in the harvest time unto the cave of Adullam, and the troop of the Philistines pitched in the valley of Rephaim. And David was then in an hold, and the garrison of the Philistines was then in Bethlehem. And David longed, and said, Oh, that one would give me drink of the water of the well of Bethlehem, which is by the gate. And the three mighty men brake through the host of the Philistines, and drew water out of the well of Bethlehem, that was by the gate, and took it, and brought it to David. Nevertheless, he would not drink thereof, but poured it out unto the Lord. And he said, Be it far from me, O Lord, that I should do this. Is not this the blood of the men that went in jeopardy of their lives? Therefore he would not drink it. These things did these three mighty men. And Abishai, the brother of Joab, the son of Zeruiah, was chief among 3. And he lifted up his spear against 300, and slew them, and had the name among 3. Was he not most honorable of 3? Therefore he was their captain, albeit he attained not unto the first 3. And Benaiah, the son of Jehoiada, the son of a valiant man of Kabzeel, who had done many acts, he slew 2 lion-like men of Moab. He went down also and slew a lion in the midst of a pit in time of snow. And he slew an Egyptian, a goodly man, and the Egyptian had a spear in his hand, but he went down to him with a staff, and plucked the spear out of the Egyptian's hand, and slew him with his own spear. These things did Benaiah the son of Jehoiada, and had the name among 3 mighty men. He was more honorable than the 30, but he attained not to the first 3, and David set him over his guard. And Asahel...
And the point is, best believe the mighty men of King David were in great physical shape. They were not obese, okay? They were not sickly. They were not slow, okay? They were experts of war, all right? Yahweh Bashem Yahushai gave them the Holy Spirit in the form of being warlike, okay? Which is part of the Holy Spirit as well, or an attribute of the Holy Spirit, when you look that term up. First Samuel 18:7, and the women answered one another as they played and said, Saul has slain his thousands and David his 10,000. Okay, again, 1 Samuel 18:7, and the women answered one another as they played and said, Saul has slain his thousands and David his 10,000s. Okay. King David was in great physical shape as well as Saul. Okay. And at this time frame, it was King Saul and David was not yet king. And also, this is another account of King David. 2 Samuel 22:33. The Most High is my strength and power, and he make my way perfect. He make my feet like hinds' feet and set me on my high places. He teach my hands to war, hence martial arts, okay, so that a bow of steel is broken by my arms. So King David, okay, was breaking bows of steel with his arms. Again, he was in great physical shape. America is finished in every aspect, okay, across the board. Lord will you edify, Shalom.